Hello YouTube, welcome to another video from Carter Prepper. Now if I'm going to the grocery store, I'm going to a bar, I'm going to a restaurant, do I really want to wear something like this? You know, it screams at people, Mr. Tactical, Mr. Terrorist, Mr. Suspicious. You know, it doesn't look peaceful, it looks aggressive. Do I really want to wear something like this to the grocery store? You know, speaking of the grocery store, I see a lot of fear mongers on YouTube talking about how the shelves are empty, no one could get any food or water at the grocery store and stuff like that. You know, just to report, the grocery store in my area is just fine. Shelves are fully stocked. People are just doing their shopping there. It's all normal. The situation is normal at my city grocery store, my neighborhood grocery store. Things are just normal. I've been a doomsday prepper for over 8 years. I do believe doomsday is coming, but I don't fearmonger. I see a lot of fearmongers on YouTube preying on people's fears. Every single day they come up with another looming disaster that never materializes, you know. I'm tired of watching the fearmongers on YouTube. It's depressing. I don't like to see people constantly have their fears preyed upon by people for profit. And I don't make any profit from YouTube, but a lot of people do. Anyway, it's just an aside. Do I really want to wear something like this to the grocery store? I don't think so. What I could wear instead is this. Fanny pack. Looks totally normal, totally nondescript, totally non-aggressive. Fanny pack. So anyway, chock full of gear. Let's get into it. This pocket, I've got a pack of cigarettes unopened. That's not for barter, it's for me to smoke. This front pocket, I've got my med kit. Tweezers, you can remove wood splinters from skin. You can remove glass from skin. You can remove metal from skin. Tweezers. Two antiseptic towelettes to avoid infection. Antiseptic cream, also to avoid infection. And three large band-aids. That's the med kit. Just the bare bones minimum of a med kit. In this little corner pocket is my fire kit. I've got Carmex here. That's not for my lips, I'll show you. This cotton. Carmex in cotton works just like Vaseline in cotton. It burns like a flare. It's part of my fire kit. Carmex and cotton. Let's go to this front pocket here. Cotton bandana. This main pouch, I've got a snack, ramen, it's pretty decent cooked, you can eat it raw if need be, a little snack, it's a lot better cooked, but you can't eat it raw, you can totally digest it, a little snack. A Coleman folding saw, good for processing wood for shelter, good for processing wood for fire. The Coleman's a decent brand, Coleman folding saw. Hand crank flashlight, not very charged up, but it takes a few seconds to charge it up. No batteries required. In the back pocket, these are $5 silver. All of them are wrapped in plastic except one, so I can show you. There's only one of these five from the 1900s, the rest are from the 1800s. $5 silver for barter, probably worth a lot of gear. Thread for a sewing kit. Needles for a sewing kit in case I need to sew on a button or sew up a seam. A Silcock water key for acquiring water from businesses and things. And a little button compass. It does work. I've tried it. It does work. A little button compass. And a Bic lighter for my fire kit. Anyway, that about wraps up this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Peace out.